Hey, it's Jason.
And Dave.
And welcome back to the Nova Game Demos YouTube channel. We're here today to demo a neat little game for you guys that we hope you'll really enjoy. Dave and I are going to see which one of us can delve deeper and survive longer to see who can get the most points in Dungeon Roll.
Dungeon Roll is a 1-4 player game made by Tasty Minstrel Games.
In the game, when you get it, you get quite a bit in such a small package. So inside the handy-dandy carrying chest, which also contains the treasures for later on in the game as you progress through your dungeon, as well as the treasure chest with the treasures in it, you're also going to get some dice. You have the white party dice. There's 7 white party dice and 7 black dungeon dice. You have the 10-sided dungeon counter to determine what level of the delve that you're in. We'll get into the delves as we play through the game. You have 8 different character cards that will determine what characters you're going to be playing as. And the character cards are double-sided. So as you delve further into the dungeon and gain experience, your character can level up. And when you level up, you'll flip it over to the other side of the card. And there's some unique character abilities as well. We'll talk about those as we play them. Of course, you're always going to get your handy-dandy rulebook as to how the game itself works. And there's reference sheets for all players. Those reference sheets contain on them details as to which characters, when rolled, beat which other characters and everything like that. So now, let's really get into it and let's break it down.
Break it down.
So with Dungeon Roll, what's going to happen is each player is going to get assigned a hero. So in this case, for example, you have the knight. The way it works is once your knight has gained 5 XP, he will level up. And if he levels up, he becomes a dragon slayer. For the character itself, they each have a special ability. So for the knight, when forming a party, all scrolls become champions. And they have a battle cry ability. So in his case, his battle cry allows him to transform all monsters to dragon faces and move them to the dragon's lair. So we'll discuss how those abilities work with the dice. So as I mentioned, you have your white party dice that you're going to roll at the beginning of each round before you delve. And on each of the white dice, there's 6 different sides, of course, and each side is something different and unique on it. So there's the gray cleric staff, there's the yellow scroll, there's the yellow hero, or, yeah, hero characters, champion. Thank you, Dave, that was the word I was looking for. Then you have your purple thief, you have your green combat warrior, and then your spell, your wizard's hat there. So that will be the different characters that can be rolled on the party dice.
Each character has a unique ability to beat a certain type of enemy, which the cards will show you.
And those enemies are contained on the monster dice.
So, as you mentioned, there's these seven black dice. There's a dragon. There's the skull.
Skeletons, I think.
For skeletons, kind of a blob for ooze or blobs. Then there's a goblin and a potion. And a treasure. So those the treasure and the potion and the dragon actually are a little different. There's 3 types of enemies, I believe. Yeah, 3 types of enemies. And then the dragon itself, which goes to a special event, which is the dragon fight. And the potions. What do the potions do?
The potions, when you get them, you can use one of your characters that you've rolled to quaff a potion and then revive one of the other characters in your party that's passed on or has been utilized and is no longer available for you. Depending upon what you have, some of your abilities may allow you to quaff multiple potions and things like that as well. So it allows you to get back some of your heroes in your party as you're delving deeper into the dungeon. As well, it lets you kind of pick and choose. So, for example, you may be able to turn a wizard into a champion, and the champions can go up against any type of monster much more easily than a wizard, which only has the special ability against the monsters of a certain type. In this case, for wizards, they're really good against blobs. Your clerics are really good against skeletons, and your heroes, the guys with the swords, are really good against the orcs or the goblins.
And there's the treasure, which lets you pick treasure from the box.
And of course, the thief is better at opening treasure chests than the other characters in your party. And that's kind of a breakdown of the dice and how they work, the heroes and how they work. And we'll explain the treasure mechanic and how the green symbols are utilized to show your victory points as we play through our playthrough. So I think that's enough of a go at it now to give you an understanding of how the game works. I think it's time to play the game.
Let's kill some monsters.
Welcome to the playthrough demo portion of Dungeon Roll. As always, I'm on this side of the camera.
Dave's on this side.
We've randomly picked our characters to start off. I myself am the knight. As the knight, my specialty is that when I'm forming a party, all scrolls become champions.
I am the spell sword. My specialty is fighters may be used as mages, and mages may be used as fighters.
Now for my knight, my battle cry, I can turn him sideways and allows me to transform all monsters to dragon faces and move them to the dragon's lair.
The arcane blade, which my spell sword may be used as a fighter or a mage.
We've already set the delve dice down to the first level of the dungeon, so I am now going to roll my champion dice to form my party. So I have a champion, two clerics, one, two, three mages, and a thief. So Dave's going to start rolling the dungeon dice, so where it's level one, he just rolls a single dice for the first level, and then as I progress down the dungeon, we'll be getting more and more dice that I'll be going up against. So, in level one, I have a treasure chest. So, any minion can open a single treasure chest. That's what we have our little reference sheets here for. Let me again give you a little bit of a close-up on the reference sheet so you can see. So what I'm going to choose to do, since a treasure chest, anyone can open a single treasure chest, and I have a whack of mages, I'm going to choose to expend one of my mages to open the treasure chest, which allows me to draw a treasure at random from our treasure box. And I have a dragon scale, which I will add there. They add up point value for the dungeon at the end of the game. Now it's round two or level two of the delve. I'm going to continue. I'm not going to go back to the tavern yet. So we have another treasure and a dragon. So the dragon immediately gets put inside into the dragon's lair. If there are three dragon's dice in the dragon's lair, that's going to immediately trigger the dragon fight phase of the delve. But fortunately for me, there's just the one there. And again, there's the treasure chest. This time, I think I will choose to expend a cleric to open that treasure. And again, it'll allow me to pick out a single treasure from our treasure chest. And I have a scroll this time. Level 3. I'm going to keep delving. Ooh, now we get some bad guys. So I have a treasure and two bad guys, a skeleton and a orc or goblin, whatever you prefer. So it, again, doesn't really matter whether or not a group of the same type which guys I use for which. So I am going to choose to use a mage on a goblin, a cleric on a skeleton. I'm going to use my thief to open the treasure chest and take my treasure at random, a ring, and I am going to stop delving. I'm not going to push my luck any further with just a single mage and a champion in my party, so that means I am going to add 3 experience in my experience token. And I am going to say that delve for me is done. So now we're going to switch the dice. I'll get the dungeon dice, Dave gets the party dice. We'll drop that back down to 1, and Dave will get to perform his first delve.
So 2 champions, 2 clerics, Mage, fighter, and a thief.
Nice selection. First level of the dungeon, you fall up against a skeleton.
And the cleric will take him out.
So Dave expends his cleric, the skeleton is gone, and it's round two. Terragoblins.
So goblins are taken out by fighters. Or for me, fighters or mages, but might as well use my fighter. Actually, we're early in, I'm just going to use him.
And what's your special ability?
Our spell sword may be used as a fighter.
So he will use his spell sword as a fighter, take out both of those guys, and move it on to level 3.
Dragon
goes to the lair. There's a potion here. Dave can use any of his characters to quaff the potion and then bring back a dice that's been used and set it to any face that he wishes.
I'll get rid of a cleric and make another champion.
So that's that potion taken care of. And then does he wish to use a character to open up the treasure?
I'll use a mage to open up the treasure.
So grab your treasure chest and open her up and pull something out at random.
Got a ham. And I will continue on.
Level 4.
Ooh, another dragon.
Another dragon. So a second dragon die gets added to the dragon's lair. A blob and a pair of potions.
I will use...
So don't forget, you can use a single party die to quaff any number of potions.
Oh, yes.
And for each potion quaffed, you revive one party die and choose its face.
So my fighter will quaff both potions, and I'll get two champions back. Got an army of champions there, and the thief will kill.
Blob.
And I will go for another one.
5 dice.
2 dragons on the board. That's dangerous. Oh, 2 more dragons.
So the dragon is going to make an appearance. With the dragon making an appearance, what happens is all other fighting stops, and Dave needs to take on the dragon. In order for a player to successfully defeat the dragon, they have to be able to beat the dragon with 3 different types of character dice. As Dave only has champions in front of him and he does not have 2 other types of characters that he can use, the dragon successfully wipes out Dave's party, so Dave will not gain any experience for this stealth.
Usually 5 champions can beat about anything, except a dragon.
Oh,
forming my next party. Champion. We are the champions. Sorry. Two mages, a cleric, and a thief.
Round one.
Fight.
Goblin.
And I will take the goblin out with a mage. Round two.
Dragon and a skeleton.
I'm going to use my ability to turn that skeleton into a dragon face and put it into the dragon lair.
Round three. It's dragon fight time.
So, as soon as the dragon fight happens, it's going to happen right away. I have to use three different adventurers to defeat the dragon. So I will use a champion, a mage, and a cleric. So the dragon has been beaten. If you successfully defeat the dragon, all dungeon dice in the dragon's lair are returned to the available pool. The adventurer draws one treasure from the treasure box, and I gain one experience for defeating the dragon. So I will get my single experience point. And a treasure, which is a potion. And I shall continue down to round level four.
Goblin, slime, skeleton.
Alright, so I'm going to quaff the potion that I just got and return a character. And since goblins are weak against fighters, I will choose to use a fighter, which I will use to take out that goblin. And then I will use a mage that I have over here to take out the blob, and use the fighter that I have over here to take out the skeleton. Question is, do I want to pack it in and push, or do I want to push my luck? I think I've pushed my luck enough. I've got a healthy lead over Dave, so I'm going to call it here and take my 4 experience for a total of 5, 6 is 11, 12, 13 experience on my character plus the dragon scale bonuses. And that's where I will leave it, so Dave has an idea how much he has to push his luck in his final delves.
I will need to push it to the extreme here. Not likely going to happen, but... let's give it a go. 3 scroll.
That can be very helpful.
Champion, cleric, fighter, thief, and 3 scrolls.
Round one. A potion.
Round two.
You can use a scroll to quaff a potion. For each potion quaffed, revive one party die and choose its face. So if you use the scroll goes away and it turns into something else. At least that's my way of reading it.
It only revives. I have nobody to revive, so okay. I can't do that.
Fair enough. Round two.
Round two.
Treasure and the dragon.
Dragon goes over there. Treasure. I'm going to use one scroll and reroll these two scrolls. Get some more faces on here, hopefully. Then I'll use that thief to open the treasure.
Grab yourself your treasure.
Fighter.
I believe that's actually a.
Or a thief. Swords.
Yeah. Yes. Level 3.
Another dragon.
Another dragon in the dragon lair. A blob and a treasure chest.
Let's use the mage to beat the blob. And we'll open the treasure chest with the thief. Dragon's good.
Ooh.
Almost tied me.
4.
And I'll push it. And there's the dragon, which I can defeat.
And then 3 individual monsters that will come up afterwards.
I thought it was just over once that happened.
Let me double check the rules and clarify. So, all the fighting is certain to attract the attention of the dragon. If there are 3 or more dice in the dragon's lair, the dragon arrives and the adventurer must do battle with it, otherwise skip ahead. So you do battle with it, you defeat the dragon. So you're definitely going to gain the 1 experience for defeating the dragon. Other side's the one there. And you'll get your dragon treasure. Any dungeon dice still in the dragon's lair remain there. All other dungeon dice should already be in the available pool. The adventurer chooses one of these 3 options. Retire to the tavern, stuff of legend.
Actually, before I fight that dragon,
there, seek glory.
Battle cry. Wipe everything. Besides my guys.
Fair enough.
But that means treasure goes back.
Treasure goes back. All the dice come back, you keep your guys, and just go to level 5, and I take that 1 experience point away.
Let's do that. Treasure potion and 3 skeletons. Well, I think the fighter's going to take those 3 skeletons out.
I don't think so. I think the cleric is.
Whoever takes skeletons out is going to take out the skeletons. Thief's gonna quaff the potion. No, take the treasure, I mean. Thief will take the treasure. Jizz. Cleric. Still losing, so I can only push it, so... but I'll trade him in for... Or no, I can't trade him.
But you can use him to quaff the potion.
That's what I mean. Yeah, use him to quaff the potion and get one of these guys back as a champion. I'll try 2 champions. And I have nothing to lose except losing, so I can't win unless I go to this round, so let's give it a go. Four blobs.
A skeleton and a dragon.
Dragon goes away, and I actually defeat them. Champion defeats them. It's 3+.
Yeah, any one type of monster. So a champion defeats all 4 blobs.
And a champion defeats the skeleton.
And that's going to be as far as you can go.
Oh, I can't possibly go except I have 1 cleric, and I don't think I can even possibly try for that.
So let's tally it up and figure out the end. So... I have 5, 8, 11, 12, 13, and then each of these dragon scales are worth 2, so 15, 17, 19 total points.
I have 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16.
Let me just double check one other quick thing here to make sure that... At the end of the player, each player's unused treasure tokens are worth 1 experience point each, except the town portal, which is worth 2. So I don't have a town portal, I have a scroll. So I have 2 and Dave has 2, so we're still an equal tie, or an equal amount of points for the treasures, and I am the victor by 3 points.
Considering I didn't score a round, I'll take that. Thanks, everyone.
As always, we'd like to thank you for taking some time out of your day to check out our video. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. If you have any questions, put them in the section below, and we'll be happy to answer them as quick as we can.
What a great battle we just had.
Yeah, it was pretty epic times there for sure. We'll leave you the link below as well in case you want to pick up the game or you want to figure out where to get it. Or as we always like to say, show your love to the local game stores. We always appreciate it if you pass it along to them. Until next time, enjoy yourself and slay those bad guys.
And make sure you get to the deepest, darkest depths of the dungeon. That's always where the best enemies are.